And how do you automate its admin activities? Some of the admin activities are bootstrap activities with Groovy. Okay, so that's the agenda for this particular one. So because in lately Jenkins has become you know, so more useful nowadays in you know, setting up your CI/CD activities, and so all your job are you know, all your works are being managed through Jenkins nowadays, not only on the development side, even on the engineering prospect too. So everyone is more dependent on Jenkins. But the problem with the Jenkins is you have you don't have a high availability for the Jenkins. Your master is down, and it is down. So you need to, you know, so do a lot of you know, customized things to ensure your Jenkins is up and running. So but today we are using containers and Docker containers especially, and we know that how can we enjoy our, you know, our reduce our efforts just by using the containers, and makes our life easy over here, right? So we can just use containers and we can run Jenkins over the container. Even our container goes down, you can launch another container just in a you know, just in seconds, and you can have your master back again running, right? So for that, but at least, you know, so if you are using a cluster, so you know, you can launch the container, or if you are using any orchestration tools, it is fine. You can launch the same container on some other machine, but you will be using the same volumes. You get the same configuration. So back to back, everything would be fine. But in some, but in few cases, you need to set up, you need to launch your container right from scratch if you are not using any container to, if you are not using any container orchestration tools. And you need to start everything from the scratch. And so how do you do that? So, or, you know, so in general, if you want to replicate all your jobs in a new Jenkins server, so how fast you can do that? So that's the agenda for this particular, you know, for this particular video. So let's go and do that particular part. So usually, you know, whenever you install Jenkins, it asks for the minimal setup, like, you know, how do you, I mean, not how do you basically, you know, so, you need to, what all the plugins you want to install as a part of the as a part of installation, and as well as what is the username you want to create, everything. So let's, we'd like to automate everything, every of that particular effort through Groovy scripting. So let's get it started. So for this, I'm just going to use my Linux box. I'm just using CentOS 7 operating system. So CentOS 7.6 I'm using, and Docker is already installed. So you can just verify that. Docker PS, PS-A, don't have anything. And this is a brand new machine anyhow. So Docker images. So I'd like to use them. So now I'm going to use, the Jenkins container. So for that, I can fetch that particular information from hub.docker.com. And also I would like to parallelly open Jenkins.io. I would like to check what is the current latest version which is available. Let's go to the download, and here you can see the LTS which is available is 2.150.1. So I would like to use the same image. So here I'm going to put like Jenkins. So Jenkins, and so here you have Jenkins official image, but this is not the right one. But if you go inside that particular one, if you look for tags, you, the latest version you see out there is 2.60, so which is almost like a 6 months ago old version. So this is not the one which I'm intended to use. So there is another one again from Jenkins, which is Jenkins CI. And over here, if you just go for the tags, the latest version which you see is 2.150.1. And so here you can see 2.150.1 with different different versions, you know, different tagging. So what is the difference is 2.150 with the with this, you know, bigger image, probably it is having the you know, CentOS image or, you know, other base image they might be using. And so here also you're having some slim, but this Alpine is, you know, so which I'm intended to use right now, because the Alpine is going to have the minimal binaries which are required to just to run your Java. Okay, so and hence your Jenkins also runs on top of that particular.
It's 1 o'clock.
So just I would like to you know, I would like to have my minimal image. So that's the reason I'm just going to use this. And I'm going to run the container. So it's going to be Docker pull. And I'm going to pull that image. So Jenkins CI / Jenkins. Just pull the image and let's run that particular image. And how do you run that? So here your Jenkins is going to run on 8080 port by default. So you can just refer that over here in the documentation page. And yeah, so there you go. You can see that there are two ports which is opening. So we're going to open those two particular ports. So one port is the end user port, and whereas the other port is JNLP backend port, which Jenkins is going to use. Okay, so let's open both. Now Docker run -d, I'm going to run it in the background, and -name, I would like to put it as Jenkins. It's optional anyhow, and -p 80:8080. So I'm not opening 8080 port, I'm just going to open 80 port, and another port which is 50,000 I'll open as is, and so it's going to be this particular image. So Docker ps, you can see the container is running good. And also I would like to follow the logs of that particular container, so just want to ensure if there are any errors. So here Jenkins, yeah, so it is just going on, it's fine. So finally got a message, Jenkins is fully up and running. So I would like to go for opening that particular server on the browser. Okay, so what is the IP address of this one? So I can just get it just by using not this one or let me pull the IP address. There you go, you just got the Jenkins, and you're going to get the initial wizard which to set up this particular thing. So here I can get the password directly from the log, or you can open this file inside the container, so which is fine. So you can just copy and paste that, continue, and you're going to select what all the plugins you do require to install as a part of installing your Jenkins. So select the plugins you would like to install. I'm not going to install any of the plugins, I would like to ignore everything, so just click on none, just go for install, and it is going to ask you to create the user, and I'm going to put like admin. Just save and continue. You can skip the IP configuration, instance configuration, you can ignore that. Just give not now, that's fine. So start using Jenkins. So here is your brand new Jenkins dashboard. Okay, but what are the efforts of whichever I try to make it out there? So I would like to I would like to skip those particular things, and I would like to get the Jenkins. If I just run the container, I want to get admin user created, what all the plugins I want to install, I want to get it created. Okay, so that's what I would like to take care. So how do I do that is I need to make my own custom Docker image, so using the existing Jenkins image. So let me go ahead and do that particular part. rm-jenkins and mkdir local Jenkins, some directory I would like to make, and just go inside that, and here I'm going to make one Docker file. But the contents, what all the things which I would like to make it. So today I already pushed it to Git repository, and I'm going to open that particular one, and I would like to copy the copy and paste the code just to make it faster. So here is a Docker file, and I'm going to use this particular file, and what are the plugins I would like to install. So those plugins will be mentioned in plugin.txt, and I would like to create a user, so which is security.groovy.